Shalom Aleichem, everybody. It is Erev Shabbos, Parshas Vayeshev, and on Motzei Shabbos we light the first Neros of Chanukah, and we're very much looking forward to an illuminated Chanukah, a Chanukah where we really bring down the aura of Kedusha into our homes and into our world. Just wanted to share with you a brief idea when it comes to Neros Chanukah. So the famous Gemara tells us, it's Machlokas Beis Shammai and Beis Hillel regarding the Seder HaHadlaka. When it comes to the lighting, do we go, in terms of our lighting, do we go count on the first night, we light one candle and we go up? This is the position of Beis Hillel. This is our practice. The second night we light two candles, the third night we light three candles. Or like Beis Shammai says, we go ahead and we start with eight candles and then we go down 7, 6, 5, 4. And the Gemara says, what exactly is the rationale for each shita? And the Gemara gives two approaches. The approach of Beis Hillel, the first rationale is that we go ahead and light keneged yamim hayotzim. We go ahead and count the days that have passed, and therefore, after 8 days have passed, we'll light eight candles. After only 1 day has passed, we'll light one candle. And Beis Shammai says the opposite, keneged yamim hanichnasim. We project forward, and since we have 8 days left, so on the first day, we'll go ahead and light eight, seven, and so forth. The second rationale that is offered is Beis Shammai says, why don't we go down a number, 8, 7, 6, 5, is keneged parei hachag. Just like when it comes to the Karban Musaf on Chag HaSukkos, we start with 13 Purim, and we go down 12, 11, 10, 9, we go down in numbers. So too, when it comes to Neros Chanukah, we start at the higher number and we go down. Beis Hillel counters and says, no, after all, Ma'alim Ba'Kodesh Ve'Ein Moridin, we always go up in Kedusha, not down, and therefore you'll start with 1 and you'll reach up to 8. The question of Beis Shammai Sheet is very obvious. What exactly is this idea that we go ahead and compare the Parei HaChag, the Parim on Chag HaSukkos with Neros Chanukah, Ma'inyan Shmita Etz Har Sinai? What does one have to do with the other? What exactly is the link between Sukkos and the Parim of Sukkos and Chanukah? It seems quite arbitrary. Just because we go down over there, we'll go down over here. What exactly is the deeper idea? That is question number one. Question number two is, there's a Gemara in Maseches Shabbos Daf Chav Gimel Amud Aleph that cites a brisa dealing with how many brachos that we go ahead and make when we light the Neros Chanukah. So the Gemara tells us that Yom Rishon, on the first night, we go ahead and we make three brachos. We make a bracha of Lahadlik, and we make a bracha of Sha'asa Nisim, and we make a bracha of Shechayana. And then the Gemara says, on subsequent nights, we take away a bracha, we only make two brachos. So the Gemara asks, striking question, my memait, which bracha gets taken out? And the Gemara says, memait's man. On the second night, you're not going to make a shechiyanu anymore. After all, it's no longer new. So the Gemara says, why not? Why? Maybe you should say shechiyanu v'nimot neis. Take away the bracha of sha'asa nisin. Take away neis. So the Gemara says, no, you can't take away neis because neis kol yomei ise. Because neis, every night was a separate neis. Very striking Gemara. The Gemara thinks at first, when you're going to go ahead and on the second night of Chanukah take away a bracha, maybe you should take away the bracha of sha'asa nisim and leave in shechiyanu. Strange. Why would you leave in shechiyanu? You lit the candles last night. This is no longer a new mitzvah. So of course, pshita, you should take away shechiyanu. Why does the Gemara not say pshita, take away shechiyanu, leave in sha'asa nisim? There's a hava mina in the Gemara that you should make a shechiyanu in the second night and take away sha'asa nisim. Very strange. Why would you make a shechiyanu on the second night? So I believe both of these questions could be answered with one yisod. Let's go back to Beit Shammai. Beit Shammai says that you go down in number keneged Parei HaChag. What's the significance of Parei HaChag? So we all know, this is the Gemara in Erchin. The Gemara tells us that when it comes to Hallel, how many days in the Jewish calendar do we say a full Hallel? So the Gemara tells us in Chutz La'aretz 21 days, in Eretz Yisrael, 18 days do we say a full Hallel. What are those days? So you have the 8 days of Chanukah, and you have the days of Sukkot. The Gemara notes that you do not say a full Hallel on all the days of Pesach. You'll say a Hallel on Shavuos. You'll say a Hallel on the first day of Pesach, the second day of Pesach in Chutz La'aretz, but the subsequent days of Chol HaMoed And the Achron Shel Pesach, you do not say challah, not a full challah. One wants to know, why is it that when it comes to Sukkot, every day you say a full challah? When it comes to Pesach, you only say a full challah in the beginning, on the first days, and not on the subsequent days. What's the difference? And the Gemara tells a big yesod. There's a difference between every single day of Sukkot, there's a new mechayev of challah. What's the new mechayev? Chilukim b'karbanosei. Every day of Sukkot, there's a new korban. Every day we go ahead and offer a new par. First day, 13. Second day, 12. Third day, 11. Is a new par. And that establishes a new Kedushas Hayom. And once you have a new Kedushas Hayom, that's a new occasion for Amiras Hala. See, when it comes to Pesach, it's the same korban every single day. And since it's the same korban every single day, so yesterday, today, the way I would view Pesach is a seven-day, one long seven-day holiday. It's a long seven-day chag. What Sukkot is Sukkot is a series of seven or eight, Shmini Atzeres, eight consecutive one-day chagim. And as such, since it's eight consecutive one-day chagim, so every single day generates a new chiyuv challah, because every day has a new korban. Yesterday is not the same as today, not the same as tomorrow. A brand new korban sets up a new yontif and a new occasion for challah. This is the message, I believe, that Beis Shammai wants us to hear. When it comes to Chanukah, do not think that Chanukah is one long eight-day chag. What Chanukah is a celebration of eight singular days, each day celebrating the unique and special nace of that day. The oil lasted another day, and there was a unique hashgacha pratis on the second day and on the third day, and it was different and distinct from the prior day. Do not think this is just one miracle that lasted for 8 days. This was eight miracles, each and every day, a new and separate miracle. So that's what Beis Shammai wants you to hear. It's not just a random link, Pari HaChag to Chanukah. The link is, appreciate and understand every single day was a new occasion for Nes. And that's why it's no coincidence whatsoever that on Chanukah, we do say Hallel, a Hallel Shalom every single day, because every single day there's a new Mechayev of Hallel V'Hodah. That's what the essence of the day is. It's a brand new Mechayev, and that's exactly what the Gemara tells us, at least in Havamina. Maybe you're only going to make two brachos on the second day. Maybe you should just make a lahadlik and a shechiyanu. Shechiyanu? You did that mitzvah yesterday. Why would you make a shechiyanu today when you did the mitzvah yesterday? The answer is, there's a new kedushas hayom. There's a new nes. There's a new occasion for halal v'hodah. And when you have this new occasion for halal v'hodah, it gets expressed, number one, in a halal shalom. Says Beis Shammai, it should get expressed, linking us in, reminding us of this idea. That's why you go down in the Neros, according to Beis Shammai. And there's a Havamina, that every single day, a new Shechiyanu. Gemara concludes, you don't make a new Shechiyanu every day, you make a new Sha'asan Nisim every day. Why? Gemara's language is very clear, it couldn't be clearer, because Kol Nes, Kol Yome Ise. Every day was a new experience of Nes. If you're like me, so when you approach Chanukah in a couple of days, 48 hours away, the annual Chanukah celebration, the dreidel, the neiros, the latkes, the sufganiyot, the family time together, always starts with such energy, such enthusiasm, such a feeling of togetherness, of halal v'hodah. And sometimes what ends up happening is by the fourth night, the fifth night, we start to wear out. Chanukah starts to sometimes, chas v'shalom, get a little stale. And the message and the yesod, and it's not just the yesod in Chanukah, as you all know. The message is that every day is an opportunity for halal v'hodah. Every day is a new occasion of nes, is a new occasion to express that sense of halal v'hodah through bon shalom, that sense of, yes, experiencing together the aura that Chanukah brings, that Simcha that Chanukah brings, that Simcha Shel Torah, that Simcha of the Yisod of Klal Yisrael's defeat of the Yevani culture, and feeling that nace, that specialness, that hashkachas Hashem every single day. Not to let it get stale, because it's not stale. It's only sometimes we get stale, and the avoda is to make sure that we don't get stale. We appreciate the uniqueness to the point that the Gemara has a havamina. You should say shechiyanu v'kimanu v'giyanu lazman hazeh every single day. So we don't make that bracha, but we're supposed to feel it. Because indeed, as the Gemara tells us, nes kol yome isa, every day is nes, every moment is nes. And I appreciate those moments. This is the yesod and the uniqueness of the mitzvah and the chag of the Chanukah. Have a wonderful Shabbos.